What is going on, guys? You're now watching China Xinhua News on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. I'm Jonathan with Xinhua News Agency. I'm now standing at a location near the Chagan Lake in northeast China's Jilin province. And today, we're going to discover what the ice fishing is like, how the local fishermen managed to hunt the fishes through the old-fashioned tools, and how this local industry could prosper by developing the local industries. So follow our camera, let's get started. As you can see, there is a shipload of fishes behind me. This is definitely a testament to the mass fishing during the winter. These fishes are from the Chagan Lake, one of the largest freshwater lakes in China. Chagan Lake means white lake in Mongolian. It covers an area of 230 square kilometers and is home to some 70 species of fish. People here save the oldest Mongolia fishing method. Fishermen first drill many holes through the thick ice using the giant chisels and then place net under the ice. They draw the net with the help of the hooks. The traditional winter fishing requires close cooperation among the fishermen. Winter fishing on ice-covered Chagan Lake dates back to Liao and Jing dynasty from the 10th century to the 30th century. Emperors at that time used to come to the lakes to fishing and hold fish head banquets. Today, every year on the first day of the festival, local fishermen must hold a ritual to offer a sacrifice to the lake gods before they begin winter fishing in order to awaken the sleeping fishing nets. In fact, there is an annual winter fishing festival held to remember the old winter fishing tradition. This year's two-month carnival will last until February the 28th. Rich outdoor activities as well as cultural experiences have been held to attract tourists. Now we are joined by Zhang Wen. He's the inheritor of the fishing tradition here. Zhang 老师, 你好。你好。 First things first, I want to ask him about why there are so many fishes here.
你好。我想问一下您，就是为什么咱们一网能捞出这么多的鱼？这个一网捞这些鱼啊，就是我们厂湖啊，这些年，通过我们那个放养，就是所说，生态平衡嘛，我们年年投放 180多万斤的鱼苗，所以说我们一网打尽几十万斤，是我们这些年就是放养的，不是说大伙说我拿一条鱼整个大鱼放的，不是，我们放的小苗都是这么大的啊，十多年了，积攒十多年了，所以说我们年年投放鱼苗年年补，但是我们一年补的量是有数的，今年我们定量是300万斤。 我们一年投放的鱼苗是300万斤，就是180万斤到200万斤的苗，就是苗种，所以说我们厂子年年都有鱼。
He said because every year we will release a lot of fry, aka small fishes, into the lake. The total weight annually is about 1 million kilograms, and we have been doing this for more than 10 years, so we have a lot in stock. So in that case, we can harvest hundreds of thousands of kilograms of fishes by just casting our fishing net once. 那么我想问一下您，这个咱们这个撒的这个网有多大？ I asked him that how large is the net?
我们这个网啊，是全长是两千米的一个大网，我们打的鱼啊，就是这个总这个面积是一公里见方那么一个方圆，是两千米那么长一个网。He
said it is 2 kilometers long, and it will take 4 hours. And the net can cover an area of 1 square kilometers.
那么第三个问题呢，我想问您，就是我们此次的那个冬捕节能捕获这个多少这个鱼？我们冬捕节是一个传统的一个节日，这个节日是指的是啥呢？是指的是这个祭湖兴网，纪念我们这个圣湖，唤醒我们的大网。 为我们那个捕捞那个传湖的大鱼，这种那个游船的这个一种那个纪念日吧。It
said that it is just like a ritual to awaken the fishing nets in that lake, so we can have a good harvest this year. 那么下一个问题呢，我想问一下您，就是咱们这个放网。 到这个收网要多长时间? I just asked him how long does it take from we cast our net and to we draw our net.
我们的一网啊，从早晨去，到下网啊，下完网那个到咱们那个收网出完鱼，在八九个小时左右吧，咱们一天就能收了这么一网，所以说八九个小时。It
will take about 8 to 9 years for us to complete one day's work, he just told us. So the next question I'm gonna ask him, how do we store those fishes? 下一个问题就是想问一下您，我们怎么储存这些鱼？好，没看见咱们这个一个冰场吗？咱这个所说这个冰上的一个超市。 冰上的超市，长湖的冰上超市，我们打的过来的鱼啊，搁冰面上打完了以后，都用咱们那个大车啊拉回咱那个冰面上啊，咱们这个冰场，所以说这属于库房，就是咱们可以这个翻炒，就是咱们说翻量，让它速冻。这时候呢，咱们这个东北这个冬季啊，都在20度以下，所以说呢，它是属于这个速冻的储存。冻完了以后，咱们现在看这个咱们鱼工啊。 开始这个分类，分解以后完了，这个打包装，打完包装以后，马上咱们这个线上的这些这个商家呀，马上就开始发了。现在看这个大车啊，这大车装上箱，装上几百条的箱啊，几百个箱，已经都马上就装完毕了，他们开始发走了。这就是京东，哎，但是咱们线上的有这个十多家的线上那个电商啊，在我们厂户为我们厂户销售。 When we harvest those fishes, we'll put the fishes on the ice ground in front of us, like you can see that. And that is our ice ground. And you can see when we harvest those fishes and they got instantly frozen on the ice ground, and then we put them in packages and transported them to everywhere in our country. 下一个问题我想问您，就是为什么我们还在用这种古老的方式？The next question I will ask is, why do you guys still use those old ways for fishing?
因为吧，我们产的湖啊，是千年的历史文化了，流传到现在，也是用这个最古老、最传统的打鱼方式，也是为了保护生态环境。 是，所以说我们用人工导养，用马拉脚盘的方式去做，为了保护我们产湖的水，保护我们产湖的这个生态环境，所以说我们还是永久的，用那个古老的方式打下去。
The third reason why they still keep these old traditional ways is that they want to protect the environment. They want to keep the lake away from contamination, so they could better use their old ways to survive. 那么我想问一下，就是为什么我们这个渔猎文化能传承这么多年呢？The next question I ask is, I wonder how this fishing custom can be preserved after so many years.
因为我们产湖啊，流传到现在了，我们产湖是一个世界器官，非常神奇，所以说我们不能把我们那个神奇的器官丢掉，所以说我们要继续流传我们产湖最古老最原始的东西，留给子孙后代。
He just told us that it's really a miracle. It's really a spectacle that we still have those old-fashioned ways today. So he thinks that those traditions must be passed down forever, must be passed down from generation to generation. 下一个问题啊，我想问一下，就是咱们冬天这个冰面这么厚，我们是怎么定位这些鱼的 ？The next question I ask him about is about.I'm really curious about the fishing technique. How can you locate these fishes when they are under this thick ice?
我们这个鱼的定位吧，就是根据我们多少年的一种经验，根据我们鱼的习性，所以说我们那个风湖的这个风向来定位咱们的鱼群在什么位置。所以说我们到东浦的时候，不用咱们那个去上冰上怎么看。但是我们做家就能知道啊，多少年的经验，今年我们的鱼的位置定位在哪，我们是多少年有经验的啊。
Judging from our years of experiences, we can locate the fishes according to the geographic features of the ice. I can recognize how the ice get formed. We can decide where the lake freezes, judging from the wind direction.So with our years of experiences, we can determine where we should cast our net. 下一个问题我想问您，就是咱们这边是什么时候开始发展旅游业的？When did we start developing the local tourism industry?
好，我们那个旅游业是从92年开始，我们到现在是旅游业开了18届了，所以说我们年年呢。定位到12月28日是我们长湖冰雪旅旅游业呀，能拉动一切，所以说我们查干湖的旅游业给我们厂湖工人每家每户带来了很大的收获和挫折。为啥说呢？说今天游客多了，每年游客照今年相对比，我们今年又比去年多了一半，所以说我们每家的那个小饭馆啊都火爆了，咱们的工人的腰包就鼓鼓的。
He said the changes are huge, and we have more and more tourists. This year is on year-on-year basis, is 50% more, and the workers here have become well. just tuning in. Now I'm standing at a location near the Chagan Lake, North China's Jilin province. And this place is famed for its central fortress of the Chinese fishing. As you can see, there is a shipload of fishing. And this is definitely a testament to the mass of fishing during this winter. These fisheries are from the Chagan Lake, one of the largest freshwater lakes in China. Chagan Lake means white lake in Mongolian. It covers an area of 230 square kilometers and is home to some 70 species of fish. People here say the oldest Mongolian fishing method. Fishermen first drill many holes from the thick ice using the giant chisels and then place net under the ice. They throw the net with the help of the horses. Winter fishing on ice-covered Chagan Lake dates back to the Liao and Jin dynasty from 10th century to the 30th century. Emperors at that time used to come to the lake to fishing and hold fish head banquets. Today, every year on the first day of the festival, local fishermen must hold a ritual to offer a sacrifice to the lake god before the big winter fishing in order to awaken the fishing nets. In fact, there is an annual winter fishing festival held to remember the old winter fishing tradition. This year's 2 months carnival will last until February the 28th. Rich outdoors activities as well as cultural experiences have been held to attract tourists. Tourists who want to buy fresh fish can visit fishing sites on the frozen lake or the storehouse of the fishing group, as you can see. And this year, the first Chagan Lake International Ice Sculpture Contest will also be held as a part of the event. Thanks to the ice fishing tradition, this place has been a magnet for tourists. I've just interviewed Zhang Wen. He's the inheritor of the local fishing tradition. He said that every year he would release a lot of small fishes into the lake. So so this place have a lot of fishes in stock. So they can harvest hundreds of thousands of kilograms of fishes by just casting their fishing net once. And he also mentioned that the fish net is about 2 kilometers long. And as you can see, the piles of fishes here are covered by ice. And this place is the storehouse of the fishes. And they will spray water on the ground, and the ice ground can be formed to preserve these fishes. As you can see, they got instantly frozen when they are put on the ice ground. They use this way to preserve the fishes. And according to the local people, when the fishes are put on the ice ground, and when the fishes flip over when they are dying, the ice won't stick to the fishes. Those fishes in this stockhouse in the courtyard are loaded and counted and then sent to many places in China for sale. So let's wrap up today's video here. If you like the video, do hit the like button down below and share with your friends on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube. I'm Jonathan with Xinhua News Agency. Thanks for tuning in. Hope to see you in our next one.